So, our presentation today is on BJAI structures, and me and Lindsay are going to call it BJAL.
Very good.
So, in many probacteria, there are enzymes that catalyze the biosynthesis of acyl homoserine lactone signals, or AHL, which is over to the right, that structure over and to the right. And using S-adenosylmethionine and cellular acyl carrier protein, ACP-coupled fatty acids, or CoA, aryl, or acyl moieties. And today we're gonna focus on BJAL, which is a CoA-dependent Lux homolog. And Lux I enzymes catalyze the biosynthesis, which is described below. And you have like the starting materials, which is the isoviral CoA. Then you have the
Scott, you can just call it Sam.
Okay. Sam. And then you have the isovaleryl and SAM intermediate. Then you have ISO-AHL, and then you have MTA.
So to test whether or not like the reaction actually worked with BJAL, they ran a HPLC plot to analyze
It's not BJAL, so it's not an L. So.
No.
So.
So these enzymes are all called I enzymes. So like the first one was Lux I, which is the first quorum sensing bacteria makes light. So they called like all the genes involved in that Lux. And so yours is BJAI, not BJAL.
Can I say BJI?
You would be less wrong.
All right. So they ran an HPLC plot of BJI to test whether or not it actually worked. And so to test it, they analyzed the time of which the components elute, and each like elution time like connects back to a specific compound. So they started by injecting pure compounds onto the HPLC plate of the starting material. So they did like CoA, IV CoA, SAM, and MTA to get their initial elution times, which these are like the first four lines, and this is like the isoavaryl, SAM. And then they put it all in one, like BJAI, SAM, and IV CoA to see if the elution times would change. And so what they would expect is that no elution times would like line up with the other starting materials, and that's exactly what happens, and that's like an indicator of the product. So this new elution time around 11 minutes indicates that it is the product. Yeah.
So in this assay, the researchers, they changed the original acyl group on the CoA compound to another acyl group. And they did this because all enzymes have a preferred substrate. So they're trying to create deviations to see what the enzyme can tolerate or not tolerate. So you can see above in figure A, there's the different acyl groups that they used. And then down below is figure B. And this chart is showing the results of this this experiment. So the blue bar, that represents the amount of product formed. And then the red bar is the amount of starting material that is still present. Or I guess you could look at it as like either used up or still present. And so in the first column to the left, you have the preferred substrate enzyme combination. So you get 100% product and no starting material left over. So then in the second lane, that is doesn't work as well as the first lane. And because you get about 75% of the product formed, and there's about 25 of the reactants still left, or the starting material still present. And then the next set of compounds, and substrate and enzyme, they they work pretty well. Not as good as the preferred, but they do work pretty well. And then if you look at the one, what is it, the fifth one, you see that it didn't work at all because you have no product form and all the starting material still left. And then the one on the right, that's the next one next to it, that is similar to the previous ones where it worked pretty well.
That's kind of interesting, right? Do you see what the trend is there? Like in terms of, the one that sucked totally, where's circle that structure? Up top.
The structure up top.
This one, right?
Yeah. So that, and then circle, go to the natural one. The structure, yeah. So you can see they made it a lot longer, and they made the group at the end like fatter. Do you see what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that killed it. And then the other one that was bad was the one that was shorter.
Right.
So, but small extensions were tolerated, which is kind of interesting.
Okay. So here we have co-crystal structures of Bijai.
Ooh, crystal structures.
So the first crystal structure on our left is showing MTA, which is in pink, binding to the IV CoA. And these crystal structures are kind of unique because we might think that we would see the IV CoA bound to SAM, which is what you can see in the reaction scheme up at the top before the intermediate step. But what happens is if the IV CoA is bound to SAM, then a reaction will occur and then you're unable to see the proper binding. So what they did was they used another small molecule to replicate what the binding would look like between IV CoA and SAM and what the crystal structure would look like. So, and the only way you could show the starting material, like the actual starting materials together, is if the enzyme was mutated or inactivated, which is kind of what they did in the next crystal structure. They used a variation of IC CoA. So right now we're looking at the surface view of a crystal structure. So they used a variation, as I said, of IC CoA, and that's called isopentanol. And what they did was they took the carbonyl group off the iso CoA, and that formed isopentanol. And so the nice thing about this is they were able to show binding of a compound that was similar to iso CoA, but like before, no reaction will occur.
That's pretty crazy. Can you go back just one second? So let's see, this will be a nice test for you, Naya. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
So can you point out if instead of they added, this is the carbonyl is gone, but like where, if the carbonyl was there, where would the reaction be happening in that structure on the right? Do you follow my meaning?
Mm-hmm.
You can look up top too, that would be helpful.
Look
so
up
you top. You circled the atom that was like a little bit different up top.
Okay, it would be happening in
right,
like we're coming off of the like the next carbon coming off of the nitrogen.
Yeah, so it's the carbon adjacent to the carbonyl, but actually the other direction.
Oh, okay. So that oxygen.
You see the sulfur? The sulfur is the yellow atom, yes. And it's the carbonyl adjacent to the sulfur that was removed, but it's not down, it's up. Right there. So circle that up top. No, I'm sorry. Straight up top, isovaleryl CoA. Right there, right? And then that carbonyl is attacked by the nitrogen on SAM. Yes, boom, that's it. There, and the blue nitrogen.
This blue nitrogen?
Yes, yes. Yeah. That is where, if you go up top, can you go up top? There's the nitrogen, yes. And that attacks that carbonyl. Boom, 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 like that. So they took that carbonyl away from the isovaleryl CoA so it doesn't undergo a reaction. But you can see in the structure, they're next to each other, which makes sense, right?
Mm-hmm. And so previous studies revealed that the formation of the homoserine lactone occurs through an acyl SAM intermediate. And so researchers wanted to get a structure of this intermediate, but like Naya said, in order to get a structure of this intermediate, you can't use actual starting materials. So what they did was they came up with a, so they developed an isoavaryl SAH intermediate seen here in pink, and then green is just the SAH without the isoviral group on it. The IVSAH lacks a leaving group at the sulfide, and therefore cannot perform its second step in the reaction, but the initial acylation still occurs. And so in this structure, you can see the difference between the isoavaryl SAH and the SAH orientation of the carboxylate. And this is where the lactonization would normally occur, but because the structures are a little different, it can occur. And so this just identifying this intermediate helps them evaluate the enzyme during the intermediate stage of the catalytic cycle so that they could help like develop the mechanism of the reaction.
So how is it different exactly? So that the pink compound, it's your turn, Lindsay. So the pink compound is a mimic of isovaleryl SAM, which is in bracket. Okay, so how is the pink compound different than isovaleryl SAM?
It lacks the sulfur right here.
No, it does not. I can see really? The sulfur.
That's what
there
it says.
Is the sulfur.
Okay, 1 second.
We can just walk through the structure if you want. Do you want to start at the adenosine ring?
Yeah, I'm doing it.
That's fine, right?
This is normal.
Ribose ring is normal.
It's this right here, right?
Well, don't compare it to the green, because sort of ignore the green, because I'm not actually asking you about the green. I just want to know how the pink structure is different than isovaleryl SAM.
It lacks this, right?
No, it actually has that. It's hidden. But see how you can see that center is trigonal? Go to that position. That's right there, right? See how it's trigonal? Mm-hmm. That means the carbonyl is actually intact. Okay. And I can even see it peeking, the little red crescent moon. Do you see it?
Like back there.
Yeah. So that means the carbonyl is actually there.
This is all the same.
That's all the same.
Are you trying to say that the sulfur is neutral?
Naya is looking at
the sulfur. That's what I was saying. It doesn't have this.
It doesn't have the methyl group.
Yeah, that's what I meant to say. It doesn't have the methyl group.
The only thing I heard is what you said, not what you meant to say.
Yeah, no, it lacks it because that's like the least. I'm sorry. I'm so bad.
I'm in a bad mood right now, Naya. That's why I'm behaving in this way.
So this is like the leaving group in the reaction, and it doesn't have that, right?
Well, the leaving group is the sulfur. So actually, this would be a good thing to do. Can you sort of, with the laser pointer, trace out the mechanism for the second step? Look at what's in the brackets, and then look at the products, and what is the reaction?
So... it looks like this forms a this is a lactinization. It forms a lactone.
It does. Yes.
And then this, all of the electrons go to the positive sulfur.
Oh, look at you, Lindsay. Very nice. Yep.
Thank you.
If you wanted to, you could actually switch to the drawing tool, I think, and draw it. That would be very good, I think. Pointer, I think. Oh, maybe you can't in Google Slides.
Yeah,
but yeah. Do you want to just? Can you want to just do it real quick again with the pointer?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Sorry. So.
So it would be a pair of electrons from there to there. Yep. Good. Correct. Correct. Yeah. So that can't happen if the sulfur is neutral.
Right, right.
If the methyl group's gone. Good. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Oh, that's it? We're done?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was all. That was all we went there.
Oh, you put some otters in there.
Just that's for you, like, Scott.
Yeah, I know. You know the other animal that I like a lot, which they actually look like otters, even though they're not aquatic, is red pandas. They're mm-hmm. also very handsome animals. But I think one thing to say about this is, like, so we include the figure of how the enzyme works, like, all the time in, like, this enzyme. And this paper was a very convincing elaboration of what the enzyme does, what its starting materials are, what its substrates are. It gives a lot of insight into the intermediate step of isovaleryl SAM because they co-crystallized the enzyme with an isovaleryl SAM analog. So it is the most detailed crystallography yet of the enzyme family, which is kind of nice. Great. Any questions? Beth, Emily? Nice. Do you have any questions for me?
Scott, Lindsay, I don't know if Lindsay figured it out, but we were trying to figure out what the gray like chain was on there.
Oh yeah. So I think it's the amino acid. I know. Yeah. Can you zoom in? Can you show that slide a little bit bigger?
Yeah.
Okay. So what they're doing, Naya, is, as you know, they solved a bunch of different structures, right? They solved, I think, three distinct, or maybe even four distinct structures. One of them, actually, that I think you showed in the previous slide, can you go up one, down one? Yeah, that's it. Right. Come on, Lindsay. Who's driving right now? I'm like getting seasick. Go up one, please. There we go. Great. So here, Lindsay, who's doing this? Up one, please.
This is up one.
No, this one. Stop here for a second. So see this, the structure on the right?
Yes.
That is... that is isopentenyl. Oh, it's isopentyl. Oh, this is the one that you talked about, Naya, yes. Where the carbonyl is gone, but otherwise it's isovaleryl CoA.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the green structure, right? So the CoA is the large molecule that's sort of going southeast, right? And the isopentyl group is pointing straight north, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then the other molecule, which is, it's actually not, it's a mimic of S-adenosyl, or that actually is S-adenosyl methionine, where the amino acid part is mostly pointing east And then as you go west, it's the sulfur with the methyl group. And then farther east is the ribose and then the flat aromatic ring, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, just remember that they have that. And now can you go back down one slide, Lindsay?
Sorry, my computer's like lagging.
Okay. So here in green is S adenosyl homocysteine. And in gray is, this is yet a different one, is S, wait a minute, I'm a little confused. What they're trying, I'll just sort of like, without maybe getting into the details, because I think they're actually mixing three different structures here. They're trying to show what happens before the acyl transfer event happens. So in gray and green, right, is sort of like the starting materials, isovaleryl CoA and SAM. It's actually not SAM, it's the demethylated SAM, but it's like the starting materials. And then the pink is the mimic of the molecule in the bracket. Mm-hmm. So they're trying to show what changes position when that transfer happens. So the one thing that's interesting is like the isovaleryl part of isovaleryl CoA, that V-shaped isopropyl group, that's in the same place, right? The ribose ring of SAM is in the same place and so on. But there's been a little bit of structural reorganization in the middle between the pink, which is in the brackets, and the green, which is starting material. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you just saying yes, we can like get out of here? It's like, this, so Lindsay, actually, whoever's driving the thing, can you like circle, let's just maybe anchor ourselves to the nitrogen of SAM, either SAM or S-adenosyl homocysteine. Up top, it's the NH3 plus right there. Yeah. Where is that nitrogen in these two structures? Because it's in both of them. In the one case, it's free, and in the other case, it has the acyl group. No, that's the carboxylate.
Is it the blue?
Nitrogen is blue. It's there and there, right? Yep. So you can see this, the carboxylate in SAM, if you want to circle that up top in the chem draw picture, the carboxylate, no, of SAM. Let's start, yeah, either there or in the isovaleryl, yep, it's there, and then also in the bracket structure, there, right? So where are those two in the crystal structure, right? They're kind of comparing what does it look like when SAM is free and when SAM has the isovaleryl group attached to it. How is it different? So the position of the carboxylate is different. And then part of that chain position is different too. So they're trying to see how does the structure progress during the course of the reaction, I guess.
Okay.
But they have to make all these modifications because you can't actually watch it happen. You have to make these poisoned versions and then get crystal structures of all the stalled points. You know what I mean? Because you can't feed the enzyme molecules that can complete the reaction because you would never be able to get it to stop and like be crystallizable, you know?
So this is like, this may be a dumb question. So like, even in like a computer program, if you put together, like, I guess I don't really know how they make like the PDBs.
Yeah.
So if you put it together, like an enzyme and a substrate together, and it's that enzyme's preferred substrate, then a reaction will occur on like electronically.
Oh, well, this this data, I keep circling it with my mouse, but like the data in C, that is a crystal structure of real protein and the real molecule. It's probably better seen in B, actually. So B is just the pink, right? But you can see the protein, which is doesn't have the mesh around it. So that's like, that's real, meaning that it's the, they're not showing everything, but it's the real protein and the molecule. So in C, to my eye, I'm used to looking at this. So I definitely like know what I'm looking at, but you're less familiar with looking at these things. So it, actually it's not surprising. C is a real crystal structure of those molecules bound to the protein, but then they deleted the protein. So you, your eye is only looking at the molecule. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it looks like a ChemDraw figure, but it is not a ChemDraw figure. It's real. Yeah, that's the, that's like the pose of different molecules when they're actually bound to the protein, but they're not displaying the protein.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. So the, those are like in real life structures. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. What's the next paper? Oh, nice.
The next paper, do you want me to pull it up?
How do you want to do it? Because it would be nice if people change partners. Do you want to change partners? The bad thing about changing partners is like one of you, either Naya or Lindsay, will go again next week, and then the other of you will have a gap. We could do two presentations a week. Maybe that would be the way to solve it.
Two presentations?
did you just like have a like a little dry heave, Naya? I saw that.
Yes, I physically gagged. What do you, like, okay, I guess that's fine.
This is, this is like an inhibitor paper.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is a fine paper. That's a,
cool.
It's not a real structure, but, oh no, wait. What was the first paper that we did? Did we do the TOFI paper, JHC8 TOFI?
No.
Oh. Okay. Can we do paper four? It doesn't matter. Let's do paper four before and then do paper three.
May I request to be part of paper four, since that has to do with some of my senior work?
Yeah, all of these are gonna be useful for your writing, Emily. Yeah, all of them will be.
Oh. Okay.
But paper four to me is the most important structure paper, I think, for us. Yeah. So do you want to do paper four and then we can do like a rock, paper, scissor tournament for between Naya and Lindsay, and then the loser can do it with you next week? Who doesn't like competing? On three, not like one, two, three, and then on a silent four, but on three, like one, two, three. You know what I mean?
Oh,
ready? Best two out of three. I'll be the judge. Okay. Are you participating, Lindsay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Ready? One, two, three. You guys are terrible at this.
Can we do rock, paper, scissors, shoot?
Okay, so that's on shoot is when you will display your choice. Okay, ready?
Oh, I hate this.
You all right?
Do you need a beta blocker? These things like give me such anxiety.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
Rock, paper, scissors. We'll just do one for practice. You're not. Okay, ready? Rock, paper, scissors, and then boom. Okay, ready? Rock, paper, scissors, go. I can't see what you're doing, Naya. You have to hold it up in front of the camera.
Okay, I'm sorry.
This is taking way too long. All right, that was
No, I'll do the paper. I'll do it with
that. So I can tell you, Naya, that announcing your intentions is a very good way to play this game. I do that all the time. I'm like, I'm going paper.
Okay. So you're telling me this if I ever have to compete in a rock, paper, scissor, like, challenge.
I think announcing your intentions is brilliant because you're like, I'm going to go paper. What is your opponent going to do?
They're going to go scissors because you said you're going paper.
But are you lying or not?
Who knows?
That's the gamble you have to take.
All right. Are you ready to play for real? Okay. Ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Okay. So you both, okay. Tie again. This is interesting. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Oh, okay, dang.
So Lindsay's up.
Oh, I thought you did a rock.
Are we doing best two out of three, or is it over? It's over.
I said I would do the paper. I'll do it.
Okay. Oh, I thought you meant
she said she would do the paper, like, not.
That's what I thought.
Oh my god!
I'm sorry. So this whole thing was just for nothing. I'm sorry. So then we'll have Emily and Naya do the paper number four, right?
Yes.
Next week. Okay.
Sounds good.
Sorry about that, Naya. I misunderstood you.
Okay.
Right. How's everything else going, everybody?
Everything seems meaningless. And
school's hard.
Yeah. Apathy.
I feel like Sundays don't really exist. Like yesterday, I just felt like I kind of wasn't present, but I was. That's kind of weird.
What did you say? Sundays don't exist?
Yeah, Sundays are just like very weird. I feel like part of the week. I feel like it's a cloud on a separate planet and I'm on that cloud and then I return by Monday. It's very weird. Kind of threw me off this week.
It does feel like weekends are not, they're different than weekends used to be, maybe.
They feel like the same. It's just another day of work.
Yeah.
Like there's separation between school and home.
I was really stressed out walking downtown. I was walking to work on Saturday and there were so many Darties because it was so nice out. So that was kind of stressful to see.
So many what?
Like parties during the day.
Parties.
A Dartie. Yeah. And so that was disappointing.
Yeah.
It was kind of weird, but that's it. That's my rant.
Yeah.
Oh, do you want to hear about my dream?
Yeah.
It's a little PG-13, but I thought I'd tell it anyway. Okay. So I was at my friend's house and...
In the dream?
Everything I'm about to say is a dream. So I'm at my friend's house and for some reason I was like throwing a party and like my like house was like partly in their house. So I was like thinking of like the way like things were oriented, like as if they were like my house, but also like his house. So all of a sudden these people from like people who are like from Ithaca, they came in the house or whatever. And this one girl was like, pardon my French. She was like, oh, I have like $1 Molly and I'm bringing it to the party or whatever. So I'm like,
Molly
okay.
Is like an illicit drug.
Yes, yes. And so she puts it in the fridge. So she puts it in the fridge. So then I'm like, oh no, like what, like I don't, like that's not like me. Like I was just like, I don't know, like I didn't want that to happen. So then I have like, there's this other, so then Akiko shows up. And I'm like,
Akiko take the drugs?
No, no, she was there to bust the party.
That would have been really, okay.
Okay. So she was there to bust the party. So I was like, oh my God, this is my party. I know Akiko, like this cannot be happening right now. So then I'm like, so she's searching the whole house or whatever. She's like gone. I'm like panicking. So then I see this like box, like this, like it was like apparently my drug box. So I see it like sitting in the corner. I'm like, okay, you know what? I gotta like change the location of that because she's gonna find it. So I put it, but I put it like in the open. And I was just like, oh, like why did I do that? Like in my conscience kicked in. I was like, that was really dumb. And so then Akiko like is about to leave and she's like, oh well, I haven't checked this. And I was like, oh, like it's nothing. So I grabbed it and she was like, well, like if it's nothing then like let me see it or whatever. I was like, absolutely not. I was like, no, it's okay. So she wouldn't stop, so I had to physically choke her till she left.
Oh no.
Yeah.
That is a weird dream that you were faced with the choice of either like choking out a faculty member or letting them find like drugs in your house.
Exactly.
And you chose choking.
I chose choking.
Yeah, that is a crazy dream. When did that happen? Just recently?
Yeah, this is like a week or two ago. Yeah.
I wonder what prompted that.
Can you control your dreams, Naya?
I don't think so. I've definitely had like where like I said, like my conscience kicks in. I'm like, that was like weird. Like I didn't really expect that to happen. But like I can't really control my dreams. However, I do have very like intense dreams and I like sleep talk and stuff like that. But
dreams like, are very strange, right? Because if you think about it, you're the author, but also the reader, right? Because obviously you make the dream, but you don't know what's going to happen, right? Like when things happen in a dream, like it's like you don't know, but of course you know because you're making it, you know what I mean?
Right. Like there was this one dream I had, I don't know if I told you guys, but like I frequently have been having love interests in my dream, and one of them was like this French man, and so he was speaking I could register that I knew, like in my, you know how like sometimes like you, that person doesn't look like that person, but you know it's like your mom or something like that, like that's just like the relation you feel to them even though they may not like resemble the actual person. Well, that's how it was with French. I was like, this sounds like French, but like, and so in my dream I was like going along with it and like I was also understanding things, but then when I woke up I was like, well, I can't speak French, so like what was that? Like, was it just like a made up language, or can I speak French when I go to sleep?
That's interesting. You probably can't speak French when you go to sleep.
I know. I'm assuming that is not the.
Yeah. But I do believe that you might believe that you can speak a different language when you're dreaming.
Right.
One of my friends like speaks like a different language when she's dreaming. Like she sleep talks in a different language.
Really?
And she doesn't know the language.
So it just sounds like she's like babbling or something?
No, it's like we've like recorded it and like we like have like looked it up and it like sounds like an actual language. We just have no idea what language it is.
She possessed.
But she can't speak another language. In real life.
No, not in this life, but she is bilingual in French.
Not in this life? What are we talking about here?
well, who knows? But yeah. So she speaks French, so we think it's because it's like a mixture of French and English. That yeah. Only like, but like her dad has listened to it and he's fluent in both and has no idea what she's saying.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
You should go to like a sleep specialist.
Right? Like it's so weird. We've done a lot of research on it. It's like really weird, but also really interesting.
Yeah, sleep is not very well understood, not surprisingly.
It's crazy. Sometimes my dreams are so real, like they feel so real that like I wake up and I'm like, did that actually happen? Or I'm like, I just imagine.
I have a lot of dreams where like I wake up in my dream and I'm like, I'm thinking it's like my actual life, but I'm still dreaming. Like it's like a double dream, I guess.
Lucid dreaming, isn't that what that is?
Lucid dreaming is when
you dream. You dream in your dream?
So like I had this one dream where like I was trying to go to an Applebee's like for whatever reason, and I end up in this like hospital like looking room, like this like I was like trapped, and there was like all these things happening, like this woman was like dying, like I couldn't really tell what's going on, there was these little boys screaming, and I was like, I was not having it. And so then she was trying to, this woman was like trying to kill herself with like a syringe full of like some sort of like toxin. So then in my dream, I like woke up, and I woke up in my bed, but I had the toxin like in my hand, like I had like the syringe in my hand, and I went to my bathroom. I was like, hold on, I probably shouldn't empty it like down the drain, like I need to like go take like a biohazard waste center or something like that. But then I actually woke up, like it was like I woke up like in my bed.
I understand. Yeah.
In my house, and then I actually woke up.
That's very crazy. Odd.
I remember last year.
You remember so many of your dreams.
Well, I write down everything that ever happens to me.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. That's gonna be cool when you're older.
I know. I'm starting to write it in different locations because just in case like something happens to me or something happens to the notes, like I need other people. And like I've told like my friends, like if something happens, like you need to give this to my children because I want my children to have it. Like it's like. It's noted to my, like, what is it? It's, like, the names I want to name my children.
Interesting.
Wow. That's so cool.
I guess my question is, like, if you write down everything that happens to you, does that take, like, more than a lifetime to read it, though?
Right. No, sometimes I know what you're saying. Like, I'll try and go back, because I have different, like, volumes, like, based on, like, the time. So, like, if something, like, if, I know. If like something really bad happens and I don't want like my new stuff to be in the same notes, I'll do like a different notes, or like I did have done one for like quarantine edition or like starting school edition, like blah blah.
Oh right.
So you're making chapters. Exactly. So I've tried to go back and like reread some of them, but some of them take forever. Some of the stuff I'm like, I did not want to revisit this. Like like that was a lot.
Yeah. That's a good idea though, because I think for people that don't do that, every once in a while, something might happen and it makes you remember something that you might have forgotten forever. Mm-hmm. I get that feeling all the time. I'm like, oh, I'll remember something and I'll be like, I might not have remembered that again for the rest of my life. And I'm really happy like I remembered like that thing, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's what I love recently about like Snapchat memories is that like I have things from like freshman year of high school that I like never would have thought about again in my entire life. But then they come up and I'm like, oh my gosh, like that was like such a fun day. Like that was like, oh my gosh, like remember like when we did this, and like, oh, I love it. Like
I've been sending them because like I'll get them pop up from like freshman year here, like at Ithaca, and all my Ithaca memories will come back and I'll be sending them to people. I was like, guys, a year ago we were in the library and it was 2 a.m. and you tripped over the whiteboard. So yeah. I'll send that back to people. It was Caitlin. She spilled the contents of her backpack all over the third floor of the library. It was fantastic.
Good. That's like, I don't remember. The third floor is like quiet too, right?
No, third floor is like medium, and then fourth and fifth are like scary quiet.
Hmm.
Gotcha.
Like, I don't want to hear people swallow.
That's great, Naya. Shut up over there!
Well, I have a big thing about mouths, too.
No.
you always point it out, and then all of us like don't focus on anything.
Naya will text us like during classes or presentations and be like, I can't stand this aspect of this person's face.
Yeah, like especially now, it's like I haven't really been able to use like the gallery mode on Zoom because like just like watching people like move their mouths around and like I just can't do it. Like I really can't.
Huh.
And like I'm just like imagining the sounds that they're making. I just like sends me in like a panic mode.
I wonder if there's a name for that, like fear of mouths.
There is a phobia of like small sounds, like light noises. Like I do not like small, like slight noises. I don't like slight touches. Like I don't like any of that.
Like, well, there's so many of those things.
I know. So I'm constantly in a state of turmoil.
Just, was it DJ that typed
unimaginable in? Suffering? What?
Yes, well, that was Lindsay was the one that didn't like DJ's on like Zoom would type so loudly.
Oh my god! Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Like every single time, I'm like, do you need to like pound it? Like I was worried he was gonna break his computer. Like it was that loud. Like it was like I couldn't do it. But.
Wait, Scott, are you still taking DJ's class next block?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, unless I'm too busy that I can't, but I don't think that will be true. And I sort of think I know enough that it'll be pretty easy for me that I'll be able to just like kind of cruise through it, you know, pretty well.
Scott, this is a class designed for undergraduates, so I hope you've got it down.
Right. Well, but what you got to understand is that DJ, like DJ was trained in synthetic organic chemistry, and I was not, not at all, actually. So I'm more self-taught. So there's like big gaps that I just don't really know that much about. So I think it would be good. So there might be things in there that he does that I don't know, but probably a lot of it I have learned in the meantime, you know what I mean? So.
Have you talked to him at all about the setup of the class?
Nope.
Oh dear.
I just told him that I might take it and he was like, great. he was pretty unenthusiastic about that idea, but he can't stop, man, not really.
So. But that's DJ period. DJ is like the most indifferent person I've ever met.
Yeah. Yeah. It'll be fun.
Fully convinced he doesn't know how to react to any of us.
I know. I think I scare him.
I don't think. Yeah, DJ is just so. He's just so like even keeled, you know.
Yeah, like in E2, everything would be going wrong, and I'd be losing my mind. And DJ's like, "It's fine. It's totally fine." And I'm like, "Absolutely not. It is not fine." And he's like, "No, it's fine."
And at the most, you might get like a little chuckle.
Yes, that's all. That's the only way he interacted with me. He just go and like move on with his day.
Yeah.
I have a video of him introducing his cat to us over Zoom last semester.
You recorded that?
Oh yeah.
Oh, I love that. Can you send that to me? Actually,
I think I've sent it before, but I'll do it again.
I'll look in the group chat right now. Lab witches, right?
Yeah, I'm the lab witches.
Which is, that's your, that's, you have a name for your group chat and that's it?
The Ulrich Lab Witches.
Nice. And then Lab Wizards.
We're all trying to learn how to read tarot cards and perform seances.
Yeah.
And then for your class, it's called Druggies.
Ooh, that's good.
We need to come up with one for DJ's class. You gonna come up with a name?
Just, I mean, is it the same people or is it different sets of people in the different group chats?
It's a different set for your class because Emily's not in it.
Oh, right. Right.
Yeah, so I'm a witch, but I'm not a druggie.
That's what I've always suspected, Emily.
Thanks. Are you also, as much DJs as. In class? Oh, yeah, for sure. For funsies, you know.
For funsies.
Also, Scott, as much as I love this, I do have to go get ready for work. But
yeah, I gotta go too.
Okay, I don't want to. Well, I do have to go.
Well, nice job, you two. That was fun.
Did you find it, Lindsay? Did you find it?
No, I didn't. I couldn't find it.
I have it.
But I hope you're gonna have a mood, Scott.
Bye, Emily.
I gotta go too. It was nice talking to you all. Well, I have like an advising meeting. I have like a work function I have to do.
You just totally ignored Lindsay like three times.
Who, me? What did you say?
I said, I hope you're in a better mood, Scott.
Oh, I'm in a great mood. Thank you.
Okay, good. Because I know at the beginning of the meeting you said.
When was I in a bad mood? Oh, was I making fun of Naya or something?
Yes.
No, you.
Yes.
You go, I'm in a bad mood. That's why I'm behaving this way.
Yeah, no, I'm doing better. I think eating always helps. Those are the first two things you should try always. Do you need to eat or do you need to sleep? And if you're still bad, then you can think about other things. But that's one and two. Eat.
Thanks. Sleep. I'll put on my checklist.
Yeah.
Life lessons.
Yeah. All right.
All right.
Bye, Scott. Thank you. All right. I'll see you.